烦得着，两个家伙，烦你了哟。
Right out front on this issue, and I'll hand it over to you.
Jordan! Yeah. So it's really great to see everyone.
everyone out here today joining together to take a stand for City College and for Prop W. We're here as students, teachers, labor and community activists, and political leaders, taking a stand really to support not just City College, but to support all the schools here in our city and in our country. In fact, today, October 6th, is the National Day of Action for Educational Justice. Did you know that? Our event here is one of thousands that are happening at school sites around the country in over 100 cities. And through the Alliance to Reclaim Our Schools, which is the National Educational Justice Alliance, teachers, students, parents, and the community are gathering and taking a stand for the schools that all our students and all our communities deserve in support of public education. So we're part of a much broader movement here for public education, actually for free community college as well. There's a national movement around that we're helping to lead the way on. And this is so important that we're here today and that the National Day of Action is happening, given the never-ending attack on public education. You know, today really provides an opportunity to send a resounding national message, and also a message here in San Francisco, that these are our schools, City College, you know, the K-12 schools that Close the Gap Coalition mobilized walk-in actions this morning at over a dozen schools. These are our schools. And we're gonna stand up for our schools, and we're gonna join together to fight for the schools that we all deserve. And that means we're fighting to ensure that students, especially low income and working class students, have access to rigorous, engaging, and quality education at all levels, from kindergarten to higher education. So we're also in support of the teachers and our school workers to ensure that they're treated fairly and they have the support they need to really educate our children. So thanks again, everyone. Yes on W, yes on 55, yes for educational justice for our community. Thank you.
And also for City College of San Francisco and all that we've been through. Next, we're going to hear from Ken Trey from UESF.
Good afternoon, everybody. United Educators of San Francisco represents the well over 6,000 teachers and school staff that keep the K-12 schools running day in and day out. I started teaching in 1985, and I taught at three or four different high schools. And I can say from my own experience, the number one path to success for students of our working families is City College of San Francisco. The people of San Francisco and the state of California have a historic opportunity in this November election. Statewide, we could pass Prop 55, which will continue taxing solely top 2% wage earners of this state to support our public schools and community colleges. Do we need to pass Prop 55?
Yes!
Darn straight. And guess what? Right here in San Francisco, and San Francisco elementary, middle school, and high school teachers have particularly want to give a nod of thanks to AFT 2121 and for our next state senator, Jane Kim, for leading the way to pass Prop W, which will allow my students and other high school students across the city, allow our students to get on with their success in higher education and careers. Thank you, Jane Kim. Thank you, 2121. Yes, on W.
So we have an incredible group here from the community, from labor, from across this beautiful city, and we're now going to have a performance from an amazing theater group called the Sky Watchers. Yeah.
Sky Watchers!
Can you hear me now? Okay. Hi, I'm Ann, and I'm with Sky Watchers. Okay.
I represent the tenderloin, so thank you for your words, Jane Kim, but we also represent the working poor and the poor who also want to attend City College and be able to do so without debt and without, right?
Yeah.
Do you support that?
Yeah.
We want to, so what we do is we make art around the stories and the lives of folks who are living in the SROs in Tenderloin, and we're going to share a little bit of our stories that came out of people's desire to have a free education. But we want to also have you come a little closer, because there's a lot of us and we can't all use the megaphone. We want you to hear us, so come close. We're very intimate. Come on, really. Come really close. We want to see you. Thank you. That's great. So we want you to join us with the song that we sing when we start each of our sessions. I'm going to let Kim have it.
Or whatever you like to drink, and bring your kids and your dog. Bottle Brewery, 1525 Cortland, again, Saturday, October 15th, 3 to 5. Come and donate, party with us for Prop W. What are we here for? Prop W. All right. I also want to let you know that we are phone banking for Prop W every day, Monday through Thursday, from 5 to 8 p.m. It's a party, people, I tell you. It is a lot of fun. Come to 311 Miramar, that's the AFT 2121 office, and phone bank with us. We're reaching out to San Francisco voters to make sure they know about W. You know, we have so many propositions on the ballot. Have you looked at your ballot?
In San Francisco, there are definitely our base and our impacted, most rural city college classes, and we know they can benefit from this proposition. So we know we can't do it alone. Since the beginning of September, we've been going up to campuses at City College and State University, handing out our voter guide, making sure folks know about Prop W, and that they vote yes on Prop W, but we can't do this alone, so we do have these for you guys to share, so you can tell your friends and neighbors, so we get Prop W passed. I want a free City College for all, we want a free City College for all, we all deserve a free City College.
Also, one last thing, after the rally for 30 minutes to an hour, if y'all have time, we're grabbing these signs and we're going around the neighborhood and making sure everyone knows what Prop W is. So stick around.
Hi, everybody. I'm an obstacle. I'm a community organizer with formerly homeless individuals in San Francisco who are really going to benefit from this proposition. I like to think of Prop W as Prop What's Next. So what's next? Hope. Harvey Milk talks about getting hope, and a lot of times the word for success, but when is it been so broadly put into action? Prop W gives hope to that family that raised up for two kids to go to community college and can now afford to do other things to take classes themselves for a brighter future for the whole family. Prop W brings hope to people struggling their way from homelessness to know that they can have the option of going to school. Prop W brings hope to our senior and immigrant community, our poor and our middle class. What's next is the rest of the nation will take notice and more city colleges will be free. Spreading hope. What's next is every one of you are going to call your neighbors and friends. Everyone you know and tell them about Prop W and Free City College. Signing up on our volunteer list at the table back there. Canvassing your neighborhoods with signs, social media, use the hashtag Prop W for the win. Phone banking, doing our little signs that we have over there, and getting people to join with us and understand that they can be a part of bringing hope to the whole community. Education is a fundamental human right. Education is the strength from which individuals, families, and communities grow from. It's foundational to an enriched and vibrant multicultural city. What if we all had equal access to city college?
Yeah.
We are all part of the spark for the fundamental right to education and hope. We are all a part of making this happen. We are what's next, and we will win. We will win.
We will win. We will win. We will win. We will win. We will win. We will win.
So I want to give a few shout-outs. First of all, the firefighters are in the house. Another round of applause for our staunch supporters, Jobs with Justice. Our incredible speakers that we just heard from the Solidarity Committee, from the Community Housing Partnership, and all of the many community groups that have stood up and fought with us for Prop W. And of course, our state union, California Federation of Teachers, is really stepping up to promote Prop 55. So let's hear it for California Federation of Teachers. All right, so don't walk away. We have a task for you right now. You can be an activist right now. If you step back to the table over there, you can fill out a card and take media pages promoting Prop W. Okay? Then you can find it, tag yourself and all your friends and neighbors to see it. Second, we're going to be taking signs and literature and information out to the local businesses in the Civic Center. Please come with us. Please ask a business to post our signs. It's so important for people to see and for Prop W to be visible out there. So stay with us a little longer. Walk around this beautiful neighborhood on a gorgeous San Francisco day and help us get Prop W out there. Sign up to Food Bank, sign up to help us out, and public service announcement. These awesome Prop W big W's and the little flags, I know they're fabulous. Please don't keep them with you. We need them for our next event. So if you have a little flag, sorry, a little flag or a big, big W, please return it so that we can do the next time. Okay. Thank you so much for coming out today. Thank you, thank you, thank you. Prop W for the win.